Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In the last video, we learned that you can take the square root of almost any number. However, sometimes square roots end up being a number you may have never heard of before. Irrational numbers. In this video, you're going to learn how to tell the difference between rational and irrational values. In short, a rational number is any number you can write as a fraction of integers. That's why they're called ratio-null. They're ratios. This includes all fractions, obviously. All integers, because they can be turned into a fraction by just using a denominator of 1. All decimals that end, because you can remove the decimal point and set the result over a multiple of 10. And all repeating decimals, because there's always a way to turn them into a ratio. Irrational numbers are any numbers that can't be written as a ratio of two integers. These are anything that doesn't fall under the forms we mentioned for rational numbers, which is basically just one kind of number, a never-ending, non-repeating decimal, which doesn't sound like much, but most square roots are irrational. Square root of 2? That's irrational. Square root of 3? Irrational. Square root of 4? That's a whole number, so that would be rational. Oh, whoops. Square roots of perfect squares are always rational because they're integers, but the square root of pretty much any other number will be irrational. Let's try some examples. Which of these is rational and which is irrational? Okay, you caught me. I made this one a little too easy. 4.9529 is a decimal that ends, so we can write it as 49,529 divided by 10,000, which makes it rational. The other decimal is so long it goes off the page and the digits look completely random rather than repeating, so this must be an irrational number. Let's try a harder version. Which of these numbers is rational and which is irrational? They both go on forever, and they look almost identical, so how can we tell them apart? The difference is this one repeats the same digits over and over again. Repeating decimals are rational. It may not be very intuitive, but this repeating decimal could be written as 1,386 over 999. Okay, so then what about the other one? The problem with this is that it doesn't repeat. It isn't just 0.33333 forever, or 0.383838 forever, or 0.387387 over and over again. No matter how far we look into the number, the pattern is never being repeated. So, this is an irrational number. And here's the whole reason we're having this lesson. Which of these is rational and which is irrational? If you've been taking notes for the last few lessons, you should hopefully recognize that 121 is a perfect square of 11. So then the square root of 121 is 11, an integer. So the square root of 121 is rational. 120, however, is not a perfect square. There are ways that we can simplify the square root, which you'll learn later. But the decimal form looks like this. Does that look like a rational number to you? Of course not. One thing to know is that some irrational numbers are so common or important, they've been given their own names. Here's one you've probably seen before. This number is intricately linked with pretty much anything dealing with circles and rotations, so mathematicians and physicists gave it its own name, pi. Do you recognize it better now that you know the common name for it? Here's another one that you may not be as familiar with. This one appears in a lot of mathematical contexts like finance. It's called Euler's number, but you'll typically see it as just E. These are two of the most important numbers in mathematics, and they're both irrational. Irrational numbers are difficult to use in equations, since it's so hard to type a never-ending number into a calculator, but they are some of the most important numbers we know of, and they make up the vast majority of square roots. In the next video, we're going to look at some of the things you can actually do with irrational numbers. See you then!